It's the morning of the fetal surgery, the first surgery of its kind to apply stem cells to the spinal cord of a developing baby with spina bifida. The first patient in this trial, known as the CURE trial, is Emily from Austin, Texas. She has traveled to California for the procedure. Emily goes under anesthesia while the team monitors her fetus via ultrasound. Pediatric and fetal surgeon Shin Hiroshi oversees the team. They make the first cut.
We open mom's abdomen and we generally pull the uterus up and out of her belly. So we open the uterus and then we identify where the baby's sitting. And we don't pull the baby all the way out. We just sort of float the baby up to that incision and we expose just the part that we need, which is the myelomeningocele.
The myelomeningocele is the spina bifida defect, an exposed sac containing the damaged spinal cord and nerves. Because the fetus is so tiny at 26 weeks gestation, the neurosurgeons use a microscope to perform their meticulous work on the spinal cord. With the surgery underway, it's time for the stem cells to make their trip across campus. UC Davis scientist Priya Kumar and her team transport the patches that contain the stem cells to the hospital. She slept in her office last night so she could keep a close watch over the cells. As the patches go on their journey, Kumar is thinking about her journey that brought her here.
Walking the corridor, carrying the bag, was when my emotions started running through in my mind of the whole process of being a scientist.
The bags get handed off to the surgery team.
Nice job, lady.
And the lab team can finally get some rest and will watch the procedure from another room in the hospital. The patches are carefully brought to the operating room.
Cells are arriving.
One bag of patches is set aside as backup. The other is opened. It contains two patches. Only one of them is needed, but both are prepared just in case. The surgeons have exposed the defect in the fetus's tiny back. After years of research, the big moment for applying the stem cell patch has finally arrived.
Cell side up, right up.
With great precision, Dr. Hiroshi brings the patch to its final destination.
Since the stem cells are on that patch, we need to place that directly on the exposed spinal cord in the myelomeningocele, and then sew that to the dura, or the covering of the spinal cord, and then close the skin over that, creating a watertight closure and leaving those stem cells directly on the exposed spinal cord.
It's the first time this has ever been done on a human fetus, a first in medical history.
I remember remarking just at the moment, it's like, can you believe this is what we get to do? Can you believe that this is the kind of thing that we can do to help people? Can you believe that it's taken so long to get here and we've been doing this for so many years and finally, you know, we were able to put stem cells in a fetus. It's just an extraordinarily lucky feeling. It really is.
The surgical team stitches up Emily with great care and attention to detail. The procedure went exactly as planned.
It was wonderful that it was very boring, right? We want it to be boring. Excitement in the operating room, you know, is usually because something's going sideways.
It was almost anticlimactic. It was perfect and perfectly smooth. It was just fantastic.
This first of its kind surgery is complete.
Wow. So thanks, everybody.
You did it.
Thank you. Done.
Now the countdown to delivery begins. Emily undergoes regular ultrasounds so the team can monitor the baby's progress. The team discovers a complication, one that's unrelated to the stem cells, but known to happen with fetal surgery.
Her amniotic fluid levels remained low, and so we couldn't send her home.
Too little amniotic fluid, the fluid that cushions and protects the fetus and is essential for its growth and development. Instead of living at the apartment she's rented in downtown Sacramento, Emily's new home, for the foreseeable future, is this hospital room.
It's challenging, not impossible. So we've done what we can. My husband picked out this little quilt. So we have like our own bedding, and that feels nice, of course. But I think it's just bringing like your very simplest comforts and just like items that may seem frivolous but do make a pretty huge difference.
She passes the time by sewing costumes for her dance class back at home and visiting with family and the cure trial team.
I was hoping
they stop by multiple times a week. It feels like we've got kind of like a little home-based kind of check-in every week.
A lot of those visits were really just to make sure that the fluid wasn't getting worse or that she wasn't having any bleeding or any problems with the fetus, and we're doing twice a day ultrasounds, looking at the baby, making sure that she was okay.
Around 30 weeks gestation, Robbie provides some excitement. While fetuses with her degree of spina bifida typically have no leg movement, Robbie is kicking.
The ultrasounds suggest that there is more leg movement in the fetus than they would have expected, given her level of lesion, which is pretty high. And Emily herself is describing what she says is lots of kicking. Now, again, I'm trying to manage her expectations too, but we are pretty excited.
Emily also is cautiously optimistic.
I feel like it's pretty easy to try and like rely on the facts and know that we're doing very well overall. And that keeps me feeling pretty good, pretty optimistic. But of course, like, there are a ton of unknowns.
With each passing week, Emily and her family celebrate that Robbie is staying put and growing. They call it Happy Not Birthday, a weekly celebration that Robbie has not arrived ahead of schedule. She makes it to the goal of 35 weeks. Robbie is ready to make her debut. By now, Emily has lived in the hospital for more than 2 months. With just days to go, she's feeling nervous, excited, and just a little amazed to be making medical history.
It's larger than life. It's enhancing quality of life for so many patients to come. It blows my mind, and it's hard to understand just what it means and just how special it is that we got to be part of this.
Up next, delivery day for the first baby in this groundbreaking trial.